Legion Tactical Cutlery.
Hold the line!
Hey everyone, how you guys doing? Grugs here, Legion Tactical Cutlery. Welcome back, troops, legionnaires, new recruits. And as always, appreciate you guys taking the time to check out my channel and my videos. In front of you today, we see the Orla OLK-033RD. I'm just going to call it the Clip Point Hunter. And we're going to put it to the test. What are you carrying today, troops? Today, I've got my Shanzu PFAL Flipper. What do you all have? Veterans, active military, thank you very much for your service. Enjoy the video. Let's go over quick specs. Again, this is the Orla OLK-033RD, but I'm going to call it the Clip Point Hunter. Overall length, 9-inch. Blade length, 4.56-inch. Blade material is a 420 high carbon in a clip point configuration with a blade hardness of 58 to 60 HRC. Blade thickness is 0.19 inch. Handle length is 4.48 inch. Handle thickness is 0.75 inch. Handle material is black G10. And the weight of this knife is 8.6 ounces. It features a full tang, lanyard hole, Kydex sheath, and a tech lock. Let's do a close up. As you can see, an awesome clip point blade, generous sharpening choil, and you could use it as a finger choil also. A nice guard, contoured grooves in the handle, a little bird's beak right over here so you can get a good grip. At least for my hand, it fits real well. All right, some light jimping on the top, mid-saber grind, and it's got a nice swedge over here, all flat grind. I personally think the secondary bevel is a convex edge, in my opinion. However, it could be just a high flat edge. As you can see, it's very, very high. Nonetheless, it's still nice and sharp. Okay, I even cut myself with this knife just now. Full tang goodness. And as you can see, the handle is just contoured and done very nicely. The texturing is done well. All right. There's a couple of lanyard holes, so I did put a lanyard here. Scales are removable. We'll see how the screws hold up with some battening. There's that guard again, okay? The only thing some people might have some objection with is the font size. It's a little big, but if you're gonna use it as a tool, who cares, man? I still think this is a great, great feeling knife and a great size and a clip point hunter. The spine is a little, I don't say rounded off, but I'm kind of curious to see how it's going to perform. All right, troops, let's take a look at the sheath, and then I want to get to work. All right, the sheath is taco style, very simple. It is a nice, thick Kydex sheath. It does come with a tech lock. Not one of my favorites. I don't particularly like this one, so I have plenty of the other kinds. I might swap it out, but this is what it does come with. So you press the two tabs, and it opens up. You could do a scout carry or an upright carry. These are tabs that are removable and can be positioned depending on the size of your belt, or you could remove them completely. Snap that in there, and then you close that up, and you put that on your hip. Let's just pop the knife in real quick. There you go. We are looking good. All right, troops, I am really excited to test this out. We're gonna do a little bit of chopping. I got a nice hard piece of wood right over here. I wanna see how the edge holds up, because there was a subscriber saying that 420 high carbon does not hold its edge well. Well, that's why I'm gonna put it to the test and we're gonna check it out. As of right now, this knife is really sharp, okay? So let's see how it holds up. Now I'm just gonna do a little light chopping, batoning, the usual, to put this to the test. I do have a lanyard and I'm going to use it, and I also have some gloves on. Again, as always, I'm going to try to use every part of the blade. Now, thank God I've got this lanyard, because I do have to choke up all the way towards the rear of the handle. And, you know, it needs some leverage. Oh, good. I'm going through a knot over here. definitely a good piece of wood to test out. And that edge looks good so far, so I'm just gonna keep on going. Even though I know I just started, it's always good to check. Definitely a nice hard piece of wood, man. Definitely a challenge, so this is good, this is good. Troops, since this is such a small piece of wood, I'm not going to be doing too much talking. I just want to make sure and concentrate my hits towards the center over here. So I'll probably be a little bit quiet unless I have something that I really want to say. I'm trying to use every part of this blade that I can. And what I like about this knife are the reps said, go ahead and test it, that they pride their knives on real world use. So, hey, I mean, how can you go wrong, you know? There we go. Definitely a challenging piece of wood, for sure. Not a chopper by any means whatsoever. Still doing pretty good though, man. You're definitely going to need a lanyard if you're going to do some chopping, because the sweet spot is all over the place on this blade, and you just need that lanyard for extra support and leverage. All right, we did it. Man, definitely a good piece of wood, man. I'm gonna use this as a baton. Okay, no gloves this time, real quick. The edge looks good. And this was some hard wood, okay? So that cut it just fine. Now, real quick, I just wanna test this. That was a nice thin piece. Okay, I don't know, we're looking good. Let's keep going, let's see what happens. This is that hard piece of wood that I just chopped through with this knife. Looks good. This is nice and dry. So let's see. And I'm already making some curls for such dry wood. So that looks good so far. So far, so good. Well, let's keep going. Okay, that looks good. Let's do it again. Again, a nice little blade to take out for a hike or for hunting. Okay, you don't need anything gargantuan. And so far doing a fine job. Maybe you're going fishing. This might be a good night for fishing. Okay. Nice little piece right there, nice and thin. Let's keep going. Looking good. If you have a firebox stove or equivalent, perfect. Got a little more over here. Let's keep going. Nice, split nice. That's good. Let me try the front of the blade, the very front part of the blade. Whoops. Well, it did start the split. All right, we're looking good. Once again, I don't know, the edge looks good to me. I don't know, so far so good. Let's try this again. Yeah, I mean, we're looking good so far. So let's try some other battening. Wow, that's just fine. Okay, let's continue. All right, so I want to put this edge to the test. I'm going to batten this. In fact, there's a knot right there. Nice and deep. Edge looks good. Let's keep going. I'll do a test in a little bit once I'm done getting through this. That's a nice little notch. Let's make it a little bit bigger. There we go. Let's keep going. Looking good so far. I'm just going to keep on looking to see if there's any edge damage. Definitely a challenging piece of wood. However, we're still getting through it, you know, little by little. Looking good. Still looking good. Okay. All right, let's see. I don't see any chips, I don't see any rolls. And as you could see, we're looking good. Let's just keep going. By the way, very comfortable without gloves, so doing a good job so far. You can see I'm not fooling around. Look at that baton. It's getting chewed. Nope, still good, man. We're looking good. We're looking good here. Let's keep going. I think I hit a hard spot on this wood. But so far, so good. I'm hitting it so hard that the handle is coming a little loose. After I get through this, I'm gonna take a little break and just tighten these up. And this is why I kind of like screws instead of pins, because if they do come loose, you know, you have a tool available on you, you can just tighten them right up. All right, we are getting through this. Three quarters through. By the way, right now on the Orla website, which is a very good website, $33 for this. Let me just check that tip. I don't know. Everything looks good to me. We are getting through this. Yeah, we're looking good so far, man. Let's see if I can get right through this now. All right, cool. Now, while this is still on camera, I'm not even gonna do any kind of editing for this part right here. Let's see. All right, I was using this. So far, so good, man. I mean, I don't know. That looks good to me. I mean, taking off the bark right now. So that's some nice finesse work. I think we're looking good. Let's keep going. Handles are tightened up. They're nice and secure now. Let's do just some horizontal. Again, it's a small blade, so... Beautiful, right through. Okay. That just cut right through the grains of this piece of wood without any problem. All right, so let's keep going. Great. Okay, let's just move that off to the side. Let's do it again. Nice, very nice. Okay, now, this is that initial piece of wood I was chopping through. Very nice, very hard. Look at that. Very dry. Again, we're making good curls, so the edge is still looking good. However, let's baton through this piece right here. That was a challenge, huh? And then we will continue where the split is. And once again, look at that, look at the curls. We are looking good. So this is a 17 degree angle that this blade was sharpened on, and so far so good. Okay, maybe a little, let's do a little cross batoning, okay? Here's a nice piece of wood with a knot. Let me clear this area, and keeping the knife in front of you, let me just clear this area. Let's do a little cross batoning right through that knot right here. Let's see how she works out. Okay, check it out. All right. Now, I'm assuming it's not going all the way through because the knife is so thick. That's just an assumption. I don't know. So, but as you could see, I got no edge damage whatsoever. That looks good. So now let's finish it off. Okay. Hold on. Knife will still be in camera. There we go. No edge damage that I could see. I know the knife splintered. I don't know, looking good. I like it. With the knife still in the camera, let me get a little bit harder piece of wood. 1 second. Okay, now I chopped this up the other day, testing out the axe. Let's see. Oh yeah, this is a nice tough piece of wood, but curls. Look at that. Curls with this nice dry piece of wood right here. Okay, nice and hard, looking good. Let's move on. All right, let's make a simple tent stake number 7 notch, and we'll, you know, clean up the other edge for the axe to pound it into the ground. Digging in real well. Okay, got ourselves a nice point, okay? Plenty good to baton this down into the dirt. Now let's make the notch. Nice and deep. Okay. That's a good start. No aid of the stump, mind you. A little thumb action. That looks pretty good. Did a good job. And a little thumb action, right? Okay, beautiful. Let's face it, to make a tent stake, you don't need something hard as a rock, you know? You just need a piece of wood and a nice sharp tool. Okay, I just processed these sticks off camera, and I just want to show you all how capable this knife is in making some feather sticks, okay? After that bit of abuse. Nice and easy, taking my time, doing some real thin work here. $32, 420 high carbon. How can you go wrong? You gotta be kidding me, man. And this is still sharp, man. It is still sharp. Okay, while this is still in camera, let me just get some rope. Let me do this again. All right. Push cut, no problem. Easy. I mean, whatever the bevel this is, I think it's a convex bevel. It's pretty awesome. It's just doing the job, you know, real nice. I mean, you're gonna tell me that's not sharp after that abuse? That's looking real good. Let's try out the spine now. I think that's pretty important when you're out in the field. Let's give it a go. So I come to find out that this part of the spine is rounded off, okay? Let me just show you all. That's pretty rounded off, like from here to here. However, this area by the swedge is sharp. So it's better than nothing. You know what I mean? And it'll still do the job. Actually, you know what? I didn't even think about the choil. Let's just want to show you that there's a nice piece of dry wood that by using the swedge over here, all right, you can make the little fluff over here, and then, you know, you could use the ferro rod and strike it over here. In fact, it's taken off my nail material. Now, this is some dry wood, right, and it's working just fine, and the wind is kind of whipping today, so it might blow away. Let me just try the choil real quick and see if the choil would work. Oh yeah. All right, good. So again, using your knife like a tool, you know? There we go. A nice little pile right here to spark up. if you don't have any fat wood, you found something nice and dry, okay, no issues. Now, bark, see, I just want to show you the example with the with that edge, very minimal. However, if you do it with the swedge, you know, and I'm just doing this very lightly, it's coming right off, okay? Give it some pressure. And I would have to baton this in half and use the choil. However, you know from this example right here, the choil does seem to work, okay? All right, and you can see that little bit. And it's gonna take some work, of course, but it's doable, all right? So, real fine knife. Let's see, one more time. Look at that. Look at that, look at the curls on that. Check it out. Okay, look at that. Sharp, $33. Kydex sheath, G10 scales. I mean, what more could you ask for, man? This is a nice little hunting knife, nice little hiking knife. All right, I'm done. I'm gonna conclude, man. Troops, another awesome budget blade. So for those who are questioning Orla, you have no more questions. This knife is badass. It's so sharp, I just did this with the fat wood. Look at that. Look at that. That's just awesome. So let's just add this to the pile. All right? You can't go wrong. $33. Kydex sheath, G10 handles. Okay? So what? It's 420 high carbon. You saw for yourself this knife did the job, and it did it well. And I abused this little badass blade. All right, troops, legionnaires, new recruits, as always, thank you very much. Really appreciate you guys. I want to bring awareness, everybody. Hashtag 22 a day. Hashtag 22 a day no more. There are veterans in active military that once they get out of the service, they do face a lot of challenges. At the end of this video, pause on the slides, check out the numbers, check out the websites, and seek the help you all have earned and deserved. Legionnaires, let me know what you think in the comments below. Like, share, subscribe. At the ready, troops, hold the line. Take care. Legionnaires!